Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we will see IO port programming and interrupt programming in 8051 microcontroller. Before we start, I request you to subscribe to my channel Dev's Institute by clicking subscribe button given below the video. It's completely free and click on bell icon to get instant notification when I upload new videos to the channel. We will start with IO port pins and their functions. There are total 4 IO ports available in 8051 microcontroller, that is port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. Each IO port occupies 8 pins from 8051 IC. So here we can see P0 has 8 pins, P1 has 8 pins. Similarly, P2 and P3 also has 8 pins. This makes them 8-bit ports. All the ports are configured as input port by default, ready to be used as input ports. When the first 0 is returned to a port, it becomes an output. To use any of these ports as an input port, it must be programmed. Now we will see IO ports one by one. So let us start with port 0, that is P0. Port 0 occupies total 8 pins, pin number 32 to pin number 39. It can be used for input or output. These are IO pins. To use these pins of port 0 as both input and output ports, each pin must be connected to pull-up register externally. Next is port 1. Port 1 occupies total 8 pins from pin number 1 to pin number 8. It can be used as input or output, but unlike port 0, this port does not need any pull-up register since it already has pull-up registers internally. Upon reset, port 1 is configured as an input port. Port 2. Port 2 occupies total 8 pins from pin number 21 to pin number 28. It can be used as an input or output. Just like port 1, P1, port 2 does not need any pull-up register since it already has pull-up registers internally. Upon reset, port 2 is also configured as an input port. Port 2 is able to perform dual role. When 8051 microcontroller is connected to external memory, P2 is used for upper 8 bits of the 16-bit address. So at that time it cannot be used for IO. Here we can see port 0 stores the lower 8 bit of the address, that is A0 to A7, and port 2 pins stores the higher bit of address, that is A8 to A15. Port 3. Port 3 occupies total 8 pins from pin number 10 to pin number 17. P3 also does not require any pull-up register, just as P1 and P2. Although port 3 is configured as an input port upon reset, this is not the way it is most commonly used. Port 3 has an additional function of providing some extremely important signals such as interrupt. Here we can see pin number 10 is RxD, that is serial receiver, and TXD, pin number 11 is TXD, that is serial transmitter, means serial data receiver means input and output is possible with pin number 10 and 11. Pin number 12 and 13 are used for interrupts, interrupt 0 and interrupt 1. 14 and 15 are for T0, T1 timer, and 16 and 17 pin plays the role for write and read signal. To know more about this, you can refer my another video which contains 8051 architecture and pin description in detail. The link is given here, so you can go to that video and there you will find in detail explanation of these pins. Next is IO bit programming. So just now we have seen all the ports P0, P1, P2, P3, their pin numbers and their functions, their dual functionality. Now we will see how these ports can be programmed. Each port P0, P1, P2, P3 contains 8 bits and each bit has address to access and perform read or write or other operations using bit manipulation instruction. Addresses are the bit addresses. Each bit address is of 8 bits which are specified in the instruction. See here, bits P0.0 means 0th bit of 0 port to 7th bit of 0th port addresses are 80 hex to 87 hex. This means that this P0 to P7, from 0th bit of P0 to 7th bit of P0. So address of this pin, okay, address of this pin P00 is 80 hex. So here we can see this address is 80 hex, 81, 82, 83, likewise up to 87 hex. So if you want to write some data to port 0, you have to write data at these memory locations from 80 hex to 87 hex. And if you have to read from port 0, then you have to read contents from 80 hex to 87 hex in the memory. So these all ports have predefined and fixed addresses to read from or to write to. Similarly, P1 port has address from 90 hex to 97 hex. So if you want to read data from P1 port, you have to read it from 90 memory location 90. It will be available at 90 hex to 97 hex. And if you have to write data to P1 port, then you have to write it at 90 hex to 97 hex. Similarly, P2 has address from A0 to A7 and port 3 has address from B0 to B7. So these all works as per the bits. So you have to transfer data bit by bit. All instructions in the instruction set using bit addresses can be used to access and perform the complement, read, write or other operations, which are bit operations we can perform on these ports by using these bit addresses. Next is interrupt programming. So before going to interrupt programming, let us first see what interrupt is. Interrupt refers to a notification communicated to the controller by the hardware or software. So interrupt can be hardware interrupt or software interrupt, on receipt of which controller momentarily stops and responds to the interrupt. Whenever an interrupt occurs, the controller completes the execution of the current instruction and starts execution of ISR, that is interrupt service routine or interrupt handler. Interrupt service routine is a piece of code that tells the processor or controller what to do when interrupt occurs. After the execution of ISR, controller returns back to the instruction which was being executed when interrupt has arrived. So when interrupt occurs, control is transferred to the interrupt service routine. Code at interrupt service routine is executed, and from there it is taken back. Control is taken back to the previous program from where it has switched to the ISR. 8051 interrupts. There are total 4 different types of interrupts occur in 8051 microcontroller. They are reset, timer, external and serial. When reset interrupt is received, the controller restarts execution from 0000x onwards, means first memory location. This is an interrupt which is not available to, or better to say, need not be available to programmer. So when reset interrupt is received, 8051 microcontroller is resetted and it starts execution from the first memory location, that is 0000. And this memory location or this interrupt is not available for the programmer, or it need not to be available for the programmer. Next is timer interrupt. Each timer is associated with a timer interrupt. A timer interrupt notifies the microcontroller that the corresponding timer has finished counting. So whenever timer finishes counting, it is notified by using the timer interrupt. There are two external interrupts, EX0 and EX1, to serve external devices. Both these interrupts are active low. An external interrupt notifies the microcontroller that an external device needs its service. Serial interrupt. Serial interrupt is used for serial communication. When enabled, it notifies the controller whether a byte has been received or transmitted. When an interrupt is received, the controller stops executing current instruction. It transfers content of program counter, that means next instruction to be executed, onto stack. It also stores the current status of the interrupts internally, but not on the stack. After this, it jumps to the memory location specified by interrupt vector table, and then processor starts executing code written over there. So for every interrupt, the interrupt service routine's addresses are present in interrupt vector table. This code is known as interrupt service routine or interrupt handler. ISR is a code written by programmer to handle or to service the interrupt. Now, programming interrupts. While programming interrupts, first thing is to specify microcontroller which interrupts must be served. That means microcontroller can choose which interrupt to be enabled and which to be ignored. This is done by configuring IE, that is interrupt enable register, which enables or disables various available interrupts. Interrupt enable register has various bits. This is interrupt enable register to enable or disable the hardware interrupt of 8051 microcontroller. To enable any of the interrupt, first EA bit, this enable EA bit must be set. If this bit is set, then only you can enable other interrupts. ET0, ET1 and ET2 are used to enable timer interrupt 0, 1 and 2 respectively. EX0 and EX1 are for enabling external 0 and 1 interrupt, and ES bit is used to enable the serial interrupt. Thank you. This is all about IO code programming and interrupt programming in 8051 microcontroller. In my next video, we will study timers and counters of 8051 microcontroller. If you like my video, click like button and provide your feedback by writing comments in comment section. You can also ask me your queries through comments. And don't forget to click on subscribe button and bell icon for more updates and latest videos. Thank you.